What is good, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Autumn. You should know that by now, but my name is Autumn, and I'm here to help you assume the position of who it is that you want to be in your life by realizing that you are the only thinker in your reality. Thus, you can be, do, and have whatever it is that you want in this life. All right. So I'm sure you saw the title today. Let's get into it. We're going to be talking about manifesting on a time crunch. Now, I have manifested on a time crunch before, but there's something I really want you to know within manifesting on a time crunch that will definitely help shift you out of feeling the urgency when it comes to manifesting on a time crunch, all right? Like I said, I'm not saying that this can't be done, but a lot of us, when we put urgency and time crunches onto certain things, there's so much resistance that's already brought into the picture when it comes to manifesting. And then the urgency is what creates the sense of lack and separation from what it is that you already have here within your reality. Because you seem to forget in trying to manifest on a time crunch that the 3D reality, the power is not in the 3D reality. It is within you, and the way for any of your solutions is present now. From whatever you're going through right now, whether it is wanting your SP to be with you by a certain date, needing money by a certain time, or wanting money to pay certain bills by a certain time, from where you are right now, anything can happen because the 3D is malleable. It's the assumption of you being a person that is in lack and needs to do something and needs to take action in some place somehow to make it happen with that sense of urgency that makes the resistance happen. And when you are on a time crunch, that means you believe that time is real. Okay, you bought into the belief that time is real. Now, we have linear time here, but remember, manifestation, your manifestation can happen right now. It can happen in the next moment. It could show up at any point. And when you are manifesting on a time crunch, you are already meeting the assumption that it may not happen because the resistance is there, because you don't have the belief that it's possible for it to happen. So the first thing that you want to do is you want to remove time itself from your manifestation, okay? Remove it from your mind that it has to be a thing, okay? Because the way is already within you. The solution is already here. You just may not be able to perceive it because you are thinking about the time and you're too invested in the 3D and your power is within the 3D, okay? Now, when I manifested on a time crunch, and I've only did this once because since then I've removed time frames and conditions and all that from my manifesting process. I don't put a time frame attached to anything because everything is now. That's why to me it doesn't make sense to manifest on a time crunch, because everything is now. But when I did call myself manifesting on a time crunch, what I did was really make myself be extremely disinterested. I was so disinterested in the 3D. I was so fed up. I was so disinterested in the 3D. So I disassociated myself from the 3D and I only went within and I lived within as if it already happened, you guys. But the thing is, there's separation there when you're already looking out into the 3D, thinking that you got to meet the conditions in order for it to manifest. No, you move that back within yourself and you're being the person that already has the result that you want. It really is just as simple as that. But you have to be so disengaged with the 3D, so disengaged with time, so disengaged with anything that is not what you want, all right? Because no one outside of you, nothing outside of you, no circumstance outside of you should be making you move. And I love that quote by Florence Scovelshin when she says, "I am unmoved by appearances, therefore appearances moved." Now, when you are someone that's urgent and you're trying to manifest on a time crunch and you already are coming from that place of lack and needing the 3D to conform in order for you to feel better, then you are always going to be moved by circumstances. You're just going to be moved by circumstances. You're not going to be able to know that you are the source because you're always rocked and moved by what the 3D is showing you, okay? So it is about being disinterested in that and only interested in being the person that already has that, okay? And the wanting and the desiring is what keeps you in a perpetual loop. And when you fall into the state of urgency, urgency shows up in everything that you do in your life, not just trying to manifest on a time crunch, but really moving through your life as if you have to make things happen, as if you have to figure things out, as if things, you always find yourself manifesting more time crunches and moving into a state where you are always missing your time crunch because the resistance that's there, the resistance that's built up towards that, you will be sure to miss your time frame, you guys. All right. And I want you to understand that, because that was something that I did not understand. The more that I was trying to manifest things by a certain time frame, I was already under the assumption that I was going to miss it because I put all my power into meeting a condition. I felt as if I needed to meet that condition in order to make things happen. When this is an inside out job, it's not an outside in job, okay? Your true power is in the present moment, you guys. Your true power is in the consciousness and in the awareness that you are the source of everything. And when we give our power to conditions and 3D and time outside of us, then we believe that that takes precedence over who we are and who we're being. And when we make that time crunch a thing, you guys, is when we spiral out of control, you guys. And I really want you guys to see that with the power of awareness, there's no time, no space, no nothing that can actually affect you unless you give it the power to. So when you give your power to this time crunch, I promise you, you're probably going to miss it. But when you take the timing off of needing to make something happen by a certain time and moving your power back within, you most likely can meet it, okay? Solution is always to move trying to control the 3D. Move away from trying to control the 3D and into being control. And how do we be control, you guys? By already being fulfilled, by recognizing that everything that you need is already right here. And placing your attention on the person that already, being the person that already has it. So that means acting from the person that already has what it is that you want. If you need the money by a certain time, you already see the bill as paid. If you want to be with your SP by a certain time, you're already with them now. You're thinking of being with them now on that date. So let's say by Valentine's Day, you wanted to manifest your SP. In your mind, you're already living that now. What did you do on Valentine's Day? You're living from that now. But if you're thinking, I hope that we be together by Valentine's Day, you're already creating that urgency and that lack that's there, okay? You're the only one that could tell the story. What did you guys do on Valentine's Day? Like, was it amazing? You know, how did it feel? Really get involved with that. And think about that from within here. Really get involved with that within here, not out here, you guys, okay? That's the difference. Manifesting with urgency and on a time crunch just implies that you do not have it when everything that you need is already available here. All right. So take the attention and take your power away from the 3D and move it back to where it belongs, which is within you, and embody that. Okay. Because nothing here has the power to be over you unless you give it that power, because you're the only one that gives that 3D circumstance or only gives that time crunch the power. All right. And when you give it the power, it's already going to make you bend to its will. All right. Are you making reality bend to your will, or are you bending to reality's will? All right. So you guys, I actually want to leave it there. It's really about the small movement back to yourself, redirecting the power back to yourself. It is not in the 3D. It is in the present moment by who you are being and where you are acting from, where you are thinking from right now in this moment. All right. Time does not exist, you guys. You literally can become a millionaire tomorrow or in the next minute, all right? So stop believing that things and conditions need to happen, and time is a factor here in when it comes to getting your manifestations. It's not. It's by who you truly believe you are, what you believe you are capable of, and the assumption, the pure conviction within yourself, all right? You are the source. You already know the way. It's already here. You just got to be able to perceive it. And the only way you'll be able to perceive it is if you believe in nothing and no one outside of you. All right. No one outside of you has the power to tell you. All right. No one else outside of you has the power to convince you. It's only you, all right? So accept the power that you have. Accept the birthright that you have. Do not allow this 3D circumstance to push you around, all right? I love you guys, all right? I'm actually going to leave the video here. Get down in the description box if you want coaching with me. Also, don't forget to leave me a comment, all right? And I will see you guys in the next video. Remember, imagination is always on your side, and I am too. Bye.